Hey guys, it's Sagar from TechWorks, and in this video, let us compare the cameras on the OnePlus Nord with the ones on its bigger brother, the OnePlus 8. OnePlus made a very big fuss about the main camera on the Nord being the same as the one on the OnePlus 8. But does that mean that both these phones can take similar images? Or does the image signal processor on the flagship Snapdragon 865 processor inside the OnePlus 8 make its images look better? Let's find out. Now, it's true that the primary cameras on both these phones use the same Sony IMX 586 sensor. But these phones are not the first OnePlus phones to use this sensor, and the sensor itself is also almost 1.5 years old. We have also seen countless other manufacturers use this sensor on their budget smartphones. It will be interesting to see how the processors on these phones handle the data that these sensors capture. We have over 90 image and video samples from both these phones to look at. So without wasting any time, let us check out the cameras that we are working with. OnePlus 8 gets a triple camera setup. Primary camera gets a 48 megapixel sensor with f1.75 aperture and optical image stabilization. Then there is a 16 megapixel sensor with f2.2 aperture and an ultra wide angle lens. And finally, it gets a 2 megapixel macro camera with f2.4 aperture. OnePlus Nord gets a quad camera setup on its back. Primary camera is the same 48 megapixel sensor with f1.75 aperture and optical image stabilization as the OnePlus 8. Secondary camera gets an 8 megapixel sensor with f2.25 aperture and an ultra wide angle lens. Then there is a 5 megapixel depth sensor with f2.4 aperture and a 2 megapixel macro camera again with f2.4 aperture. Macro cameras on both these phones are pretty much useless. No matter how much light you give them, they just won't take good images. And this is with the latest update installed on the OnePlus Nord, which was supposed to improve the macro performance of this phone. The depth sensor on the Nord is also pretty much useless, because the phone can take just as good portrait shots even if you cover this sensor. So when we really look at it, both these phones just have two good usable cameras on their back. At the front, OnePlus 8 gets the same 16 megapixel Sony IMX 471 sensor with f2.45 aperture that OnePlus has been using since quite a few years. Nord gets two cameras at the front. The primary camera gets an upgraded 32 megapixel Sony IMX 616 sensor with f2.45 aperture. Secondary camera gets an 8 megapixel sensor with f2.45 aperture and it gets a wide angle lens. The interface of the camera app is pretty similar on both the phones. If you want a closer look at it, I suggest you guys check out my dedicated camera reviews of both these phones. I will leave card to them on the top right corner of the screen and also link them in the description section. Now, before we head over to the image and video samples, if you are new to this channel, please make sure to hit the subscribe button and the bell icon next to it. That way, you won't miss out on any of the amazing videos coming up on this channel. Let us start with the daytime images. Although it is monsoon season, I managed to get some images in bright lighting conditions for this comparison video. Both the phones are using the same sensor, so we don't really see a big difference in the level of details that they capture. If anything, you can see a slight difference in the way both of them capture colors. OnePlus 8 is also a bit more aggressive with the ultra-short HDR. It triggers more often on this phone compared to the OnePlus Nord. Basically, 9 out of 10 times looking at these well-lit images, you won't be able to point out that one image is better than the other. And this is a huge win for the OnePlus Nord. Because right now, there is a 14,000 rupees difference between the price of both these phones. And that difference will get even bigger when the 25,000 rupees variant of the OnePlus Nord goes on sale sometime in September. As I said, there is a slight difference in the way both of them capture colors. The difference is very subtle, but the OnePlus Nord captures more saturated colors. Few of its images are also much brighter, so you might have to pull the brightness slider down manually to get back some of the details from those brighter areas. Overall, both are not showing the natural colors or how the scene actually was. On occasion, OnePlus Nord captures cooler colors and the OnePlus 8 captures warmer tones, and in the very next image, we see this the other way around. So both of them are not very consistent with colors. That being said, when you look at these images on your smartphone, both of them look very good on their own. If you saw my dedicated camera review of these two phones, you know that both of them can take very good HDR shots. So for all of these shots, I have kept the UltraShot HDR on auto on both these phones. As you can see, both are doing a very good job with these images. They bring up enough details from the shadows and preserve the details in the highlights of the sky really well. This one would have been a very difficult shot for any camera, but both these phones managed to pull it off. Most of the smartphones would have captured a dark silhouette in this case, but these two managed to bring up the shadows and make the overall image look very good. So the main camera on the OnePlus Nord is still neck to neck with the one on the OnePlus 8. Coming to the close-up shots, since both have a very big sensor and a wide aperture, background in these images get a very nice optical blur. The subject closest to the camera on the one that you tap on is in perfect sharp focus. OnePlus 8 is faster at setting the focus on any object compared to the OnePlus Nord. Bigger sensor makes these close-up shots look very good, but this also brings out a different issue. The plane of focus becomes very shallow, so the closer you get to any subject, the main area in focus becomes smaller and smaller. This doesn't look very good, especially if you have text next to your main subject. It can look very distorted, like you can see in these images. If you want to get even closer to your subject, both phones get dedicated macro cameras. While capturing a subject from up close and being able to see more details sound cool and all, but the actual macro sensors are of very low resolution and the aperture is also not very wide, making these macro shots look really bad from both these phones. You can end up taking better close-up shots by zooming in 2-3 times with the main camera. Here are a few macro shots, and now the same scene captured with 2-3 times digital zoom with the main camera. I started using this trick whenever I need to capture macro or tight close-up shots. Both of them also get a wide lens on their back, and here is how much more of the scene these wide lenses let you capture compared to the primary lens. Wide camera on the OnePlus 8 has a high resolution sensor, and it shows when we zoom in on these wide shots. OnePlus 8's images are sharper and show so much more details compared to the Nord's wide angle images. Although wide images from the Nord are not as good, they still look usable when we look at them alone. And I'm still glad to get a wide lens on both these phones, as it lets us capture a different perspective of the scene by standing at the same exact spot. It specially comes in handy when you are trying to capture a huge architecture like this and there is no more space to move back. These phones don't have a 2x telephoto lens, but they still get a 2x button on the viewfinder. Tapping on this button on both the phones captures 2x digitally zoomed in images. If you think you are going to take a lot of wide angle images on your phone, I think you should go with the OnePlus 8. So far, images that we saw from the main cameras on both these phones were 12 megapixel pixel binned ones. But if you want, they also let you capture 48 megapixel images. These images are identical from both the phones, which is not a surprise as they have the same sensor. These images capture more details than the 12 megapixel ones when there is bright light around. But you will have to zoom in 4-5 times to see this difference, which we don't usually do on our smartphones. And these images also take 2-3 times more storage space than the 12 megapixel ones. So my suggestion will be, you should stick to the default 12 megapixel mode for most of your shots. Now moving on to the portrait mode. Recently, I got an update on the OnePlus Nord which has improved the edge detection for these portrait shots. Looking at these portrait shots side by side, it is hard to say which one did better. The depth sensor on the Nord is useless because I took 4 of these images with that lens covered and the portraits still turned out to be this good. The main subject is a bit sharper in the portraits from the OnePlus 8 and it also shows slightly better colors. But the difference is barely visible if you don't know what you're looking for. You can also take 2x zoomed in portraits with both the phones, but I feel they are a bit too soft for my liking, so I stick to the normal wide portrait shots. There is a slight difference in the way both of them capture skin tones, but one is not necessarily better than the other. You can look at these portrait shots and decide for yourself which one looks better to you. For me, I will go with the OnePlus 8 because of the slightly better colors and more details in the subject. But the difference is so little that it really doesn't matter which one you pick to take portrait shots. Both of them can take portraits of objects. While both are equally good at detecting the edges and making their portraits of objects look good, the OnePlus Nord takes noticeably longer to detect these edges. The resulting images are again almost identical from both except for the very minute difference in color. No matter how complex the objects are, both of them are doing a very good job with these portrait shots. Now let us move on to the images that I took in indoors, artificial and lower lighting situations. These indoor images with a lot of ambient light look good from both the phones, but when we zoom in, image from the Nord is showing more noise while the ISP on the OnePlus 8 helps keep the noise level down. Both of them have OIS on the main camera and a wide aperture which lets them capture more light for a longer time, resulting in better images in lower light. In even lower lighting conditions, Nord tries to increase the ISO to make the images brighter. As you can see, it works. but it also introduces a lot of noise in its images. The OnePlus 8's images are not as bright, but there is less noise and a bit more details in its images. Both the phones get nightscape mode, and using it indoors results in even better images with more details. When you take images outdoors in nighttime, if there is any ambient light around, both these phones do very well and capture a lot of details. When the light is very low, like in this shot, you can switch to the nightscape mode and look at the difference that it makes. With this mode turned on, the OnePlus 8 captures less noise compared to the OnePlus Nord. Even without the nightscape mode, OnePlus 8 takes brighter images in some cases. Again, with the nightscape mode turned on, both the phones make these images look so much better. While the images from the OnePlus 8 are better in most lower lighting conditions, the difference is not much, which is a very big compliment for the OnePlus Nord. Most of the differences that we see are because we are comparing these images side by side. On their own, Nord's images look just as good. That brings us to the front-facing cameras. OnePlus Nord has a high-resolution selfie camera, and as we zoom in on these selfies, we see it is capturing more details, whereas the OnePlus 8's images have a bit of noise in them. OnePlus Nord also gets a secondary wide lens at the front, which will let you get more of your friends in one shot. This lens is a bit soft compared to the primary one, but it is still nice to have a different focal length for the front-facing camera as well. When you take selfies outside, there isn't a big difference between the selfies from both these phones. The OnePlus Nord, however, has a slightly wider field of view on its main selfie camera. Edge detection is pretty much same in the portrait selfies from both the phones. I feel the skin tones are looking more natural in the portrait selfies from the OnePlus 8. Both of them do a very good job with edge detection, even if you have multiple faces in your selfies. Overall, selfies are more detailed from the OnePlus Nord, but even if you choose the OnePlus 8, you won't notice a huge difference in the resulting selfies. Here is a video from the front-facing camera of the OnePlus Nord and the OnePlus 8. You can see how both these phones are handling the overall colors of the scene, exposure, and stabilization when I'm walking around with them. When it comes to shooting videos, OnePlus 8 can take 4K videos at 60fps, but for some reason, Nord can only capture 4K videos at 30fps. Electronic stabilization is at work on both the phones, and it does an amazing job of keeping these videos very smooth. Here is a short montage of videos from both the phones. One from the OnePlus 8 has been shot in 4K at 60fps, and the Nord's video has been shot at 1080p resolution in 60fps. If you want the highest resolution video, then go with the OnePlus 8. Else, 4K and 1080p videos from the OnePlus Nord are also looking very good. So we just saw over 90 image and video samples from both these phones. I made sure to include these image samples in as many lighting conditions as possible. Other than the images from the OnePlus 8 being slightly better in lower light, I think it is safe to say that there is barely any difference between the camera performance of both these phones. I mean, you will find a few differences if you have a very keen eye, but these differences are definitely not worth the extra 14,000 rupees in my opinion. If you want an overall better phone with flagship specifications, and if you don't mind spending the extra money, then definitely go with the OnePlus 8. But if your budget is limited to under 30,000 rupees, then you can go with the OnePlus Nord, and actually be proud of the fact that the cameras on your phone can go neck to neck with the ones on the OnePlus 8. Now you guys saw all these images too, so which one do you think did better? Let me know in the comments. If you like any one of these phones and you are going to purchase them, I will really appreciate if you get it from the affiliate links in the description section. That is it for this video, guys. Please hit the like button if you enjoyed this video and subscribe to the channel for more quality tech videos like this. You can also check out some of the other videos from this channel. This has been Sagar, and I'll catch you guys in the next video. Take care.